Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to GameStay TV. Nice short break there. We are moving on into round number four of the DarkSTAH Gears of War weeklies, week number two qualifier. Nice long name there. So you can see on the bracket, we've got two matches lined up, Cap and Deej and Disciples versus Mikey Production Studios. Now, we would have liked to have Mikey Production Studios on a stream. Unfortunately, not able to do so tonight because that would have meant having Cap and Deej on for a third game in a row. And we don't want to have that. So what we're going to be doing is bringing you Freak Show versus Thunder from Down Under. And we're expecting this to be quite a close match. Both teams getting it handed to them by these two very high-level teams of Mind Freak and Cap and Deej and Disciples. So looking forward to a nice close match from the Freak Show and Thunder Down Under. My name is Crisis. I'm joined once again by Rogi. And it's been a good evening so far, Rogi. And hopefully it's going to be a great finish to it too.
Oh, yeah. I'm really excited for this game. I'm especially coming off the match against Mind Freak versus Captain DJ and the Disciples. Looking for another close one, unfortunately, for the boys on Freak Show. They had a real rough showing against the Disciples. But how can you blame them after that team came off fresh from a win with Mind Freak? I don't think anyone could have stopped them.
Yeah.
But now they're up against Thunder from Down Under, who also, unfortunately, coming off a little bit of a loss to Mind Freak as well. Just getting the ready, waiting for the ready check from Captain Deej. Not Captain Deej. I'm so used to saying this. We've had them on all night.
So
getting the ready check from Freak Show.
While we're waiting for that ready check, I'll just do a quick refresh of the brackets and show everybody the standings at the moment. Cap and Deej and Disciples on a 3-0 right now with Mind Freak on 2-1. Now, Mind Freak aren't playing in this final round. They get a bye, and that's an unfortunate result of us having five teams. We really need to have even teams, ladies and gentlemen. So if you're thinking about joining in, make sure you just get four of your mates together and have a go at it. Get yourself some competitive Gears of War on. And so Mikey Production Studios, the new kid on the block, picking up a 1-1 with one bye. So we award full points for the buys. So even though Mind Freak isn't playing, they will get an extra point for it. As we get into this match, coming right up.
Yep. We're going to be playing Harbor for this time. Excited to see how this one goes. Harbor, definitely need a lot of teamwork and coordination if you want to lock down the very important points on the map, such as the Stern and that B Hill. Always an interesting byproduct of Harbor is you need to impact the map with your lances more than your Nashes, especially when you get winch control going down onto dock. It's the lance of crossfire just has to be there, because if you're letting the other team take control of B while you have winch, you're playing it wrong. So I want to jump on board with Pricey. You got MVP for us last round. Curious to see if you can do it again. Where's our boy Pricey? Here we go. John on board with Pricey this time around. No sniper on the map to start things off, so he's only going to be popping domes immediately. Looks like he will be playing the B Hill for his team. Like to see that. Got the smoke grenade out. Wonder where he's going to place it, because smoke grenade is very important. Oh, throws it straight in the water. Going to have to work on that one a little bit, Pricey. I'm going to be coming through. Looks like Pricey's going for the rush on gear let. Going for the up A. No, accidentally rolls. So a misplay coming to the Pricey. Can allow gear let to come in and actually clean up two kills. She takes out Harrison. Getting control of the B Hill in a series of unfortunate events coming out of Freak Show. Great cross pistol from gear let. Going to be taking him down to full red. Don't be right. Needs to be very, very careful with this one. You can see solid Mantella. Kind of hanging up, gonna have to avoid this push coming through from Pricey. Actually backs off a little bit too far. Pricey is gonna get control of the ramp. You're going for the pistol, maybe the double melee, not gonna happen as Pricey picks up that one. Lady Luck is getting some great lance and fire down onto Pricey. Now, for the smoke grenade, gonna be able to get the stun that's gonna allow him to get in, get the free kill onto Lady Luck. One more shot should do it. Perfidy goes down as Gearlet falls. Harrison with the team kill. Unfortunate stuff out of that one. Fred from Subway just hiding away, but Pricey embarrasses him. Look at my Pricey. Wants to go for the 3 cap here, actually. Assault Mantella, the only player left alive. I think the Pricey, someone just disconnected.
Yeah, Solid Mantella just DC'd. So, is there a pause function? Can we pause?
No, unfortunately not. They'll just have to get back in as soon as possible. What they can do, depending on these teams know the... I'll try and invite while this game goes on so they can keep playing.
All right, no worries. So, we're on board right now with Gumby Riot at the moment. He's on a 4-5 situation with Solid just dropping off there. A moment ago, gets the lancer across the distance there. Doesn't do much damage. He's getting some loving from Lady Luck, and Lady Luck takes him down in the end there. In fact, I think I was calling for the wrong side, saying the wrong side was in a 4-5 situation.
It's so good. Looks like Solid Mantella is back in the game. She just needs to load back in, and then we'll spawn enemy good to go. But a great job in this 4v5 to keep the dream alive, coming from Thunder from down under. They're doing work, actually, in pretty much all angles on the map, and there, Solid Mantella entered the game. So she'll be respawning any second now to help the team back out. They're going for a 3 cap, actually. If they're able to pull off a round win in a 4v5, that would be absolutely miraculous. You can see Perfidy getting some great cross lancer down, and Lady Luck with the double. Can she get the triple? She needs to right now. She does! What an amazing series of events. If they get the 3 cap, a 4v5 to win the first round, the Thunder from down under is absolutely popping off. Incredible stuff, and looks like Solid Mantella is back in the game.
Well, can sort of get the picnic basket, head off to the corner, and have a little bit of a rest while the team carries him, her? I don't know.
Yeah, I'm not too sure. I've been told Solid Mantella, Lady Luck, and Gearlet, women as far as I'm aware. So if I do mess up, that's just force of habit. I do apologize in advance, as when casting, you just got to say the first thing that comes to your head. So I'll try my best to be as respectful as I can.
Well, what we can do is we can set up a safe space somewhere. So if we do get the pronouns wrong, we've got somewhere to go to. So into round number 2, it's a 1-0 at the moment in favor of a very strong Thunder Thunder.
Oh, yeah, you got to check if it's storming outside, because the thunder is loud right now. It's Perfidy going for a shot, but Pricey puts her in the ground. A great shot coming out of that. Now Lady Luck wants to try her luck and gets it with a huge kill onto Pricey. Will Lady Luck go from here? Then we get the cross lancer onto Gumby Riot. She's got one of her teammates up there. It's going to be Gearlet taking out Harrison as Fred gets the kill onto Gumby. And Lady Luck going to be going for the rotate onto the enemy team home hill. That's a great one if they get there in time, as Fred takes that transfixion. Pricey going to be making his way on in. He needs to do work right now. He needs to come up huge. The Lady Luck not going to allow him. Could be a triple cast coming through. Naysay able to find one. Lady Luck uncharacteristically misses a very easy shot as Harrison rolls directly into her and somehow returns with a kill. So that's going to be the dream alive still for Freak Show. They're not done yet. Harrison and Gumby Riot, they need to decide how they're going to go about playing this one, as they're not in a very good position. I'm going to jump on board with Perfidy. Just hanging back with the Lancer, making sure that no one can go for any cheeky plays. Some great crossfire down, and it's a transfixion. Unfortunately, it's another team kill. We've seen a lot of team kills actually coming out of Freak Show here, and you hate to see it. 1v1 on the enemy team home hill. Harrison is going to be able to defend up against Fred from Subway, but Freak Show, they found themselves in quite a bit of a point deficit at the moment. Harrison, using that wall bouncing well, rolls directly into Perfidy. Needs to hit with the accuracy. Just take your time! Can't connect with the shot as Perfidy takes him out now. Perfidy on the enemy team home hill, getting some great cross lancer in the back. 5 seconds left on the trip cap. They need to get in the kill. They need to do it now. Gumby Riot rolls to the side. There's going to be a smoke grenade tag. The ultimate of ultimate BM to take down. Gets the kill onto Naysay. Gets the kill onto Gumby Riot. Perfidy playing out of his freaking mind right now. We're going to be 2 more as they're making their way up. Hits the third. Right. Can he be the fourth? Can he be one more? That's all Perfidy needs to complete the quadrant. You're not going to find it, though. The Lady Luck has his back, and that's going to be another round of Thunder from Down Under.
Oh, Thunder from Down Under. Very, very strong through that, and great to follow Perfidy through that. The strongest French-speaking player in Oceania, I believe.
Without a doubt.
Without a doubt. Très bien.
Curious if from France or maybe from New Caledonia, where I know they also speak French.
Or just a really high-achieving school learner.
That's true. I did French in high school, and it was not easy.
I did a year of French at university, and I was so good at it, at the end of the year, I had to go and beg my lecturer to pass me. Oh, dear. Anyway.
give us your best, give us a sentence in French, Crassus. Make Perfini's ears cringe.
Je voudrais un bisou.
I'm sure his skin's going to be crawling.
Oh, for sure.
Because he gets downed. Oh, no, the French curse. Too real right now as Perfini just put in the ground. Pricey gives a great cross, lands it down, spread from Subway. Takes him out. How did I miss that? There's snipers on either side of the map right now. Naysayer has theirs. For Freak Show, and Fred from Subway has his four. Thunder from Down Under. Oh, another shot comes out from Fred from Subway. Gumby Riot goes down. Beautiful stuff, Fred. That's his second headshot back to back already. I like this. Wise play rotating the sniper rifle up, looking down at the B Hill. Transfiction gets a kill onto Gearlet. Naysayer trying to make his sniper rifle work. I'm surprised they didn't give that to Pricey, considering how much of a beaster the man is when he has the sniper in his hands. Fred kind of rotating the rifle back around to the winch. Naysayer, maybe that's why, because he's popping off right now. But Mini goes down. Pricey with a huge wall bounce. This could be what he needs to overextend to the C hill. They're taking over B right now. If Pricey can get onto C, they could go for the three cap and get Freecho's first round on the board. But unfortunately, Pricey misrolls there, trying to take cover, rolls on the spot. Last thing you want to see in such a crucial situation. So Lady Luck now on board with her. She's going to be moving up the winch, trying to get recontrol. We know that Gumby Riot is hanging around, but I actually want to jump on board with Naysayer. He's got himself the sniper in his hands. Looking down the barrel. I just want to rotate. He's already got one headshot on the board. Sees Perfidy and Lady Luck in his sights, looking for someone. Oh, hits the body shot. Takes him down. That's going to be Pricey to connect. Harrison gets another headshot. Looking over the scope. Trying to find the kill onto Fred. Not going to do it. Moving up now, Transfiction in the 1v1 over on the B hill. He goes down, but he's got a teammate in Harrison to pick him up. Solid man, tell her she needs to come up huge. She needs to get the kills to back it up, but the melee will be enough as Harrison takes her down. That's going to be a few kills going over the Freak Shield. They could potentially be making a trip cap right now, but Gearlet has something to say about that. She's the last player left alive in the home hill, but I don't think it matters. Look at the point differential. That's a 60-point lead coming through for Freak Show right now. The snipers on the map really benefiting them very well as Transfiction trying to go for kill on to Lady Luck. Perfidy, though, has something to say about that one. Wants to go for the play. Not going to find anything as Gearlet goes down to Harrison. 10 seconds left on the clock. They need to go for the double break, and they need to do it now. Time is running out for Thunder from Down Under. I think they get the B, but it's not going to matter. Round number three. First round for Pricey's team. Freak Show.
Yeah, they get the donut off the board. They'll be pleased with that. Oh, let's get the scores up. Don't have the scores on.
Right, 2-2 Thunder from Down Under, 1 to Freak Show.
Yes, yep. I've got that. I've been filling in the scores. I just didn't have the scoreboard on the screen. So, all good. 2-1. And as predicted, or as we hoped, Rogi, we've got a close game on our hands.
Yeah, I want to jump on board with Prizey for this round because I know that this man, when that sniper is in his hands, can be an absolute monster. I'm curious to why he would let that slide and give it over to Naysayer, but I think maybe he just wants to be the tip of the spear for his team with the Nash, and it looks like he will be doing that once again. He wants to get into the thick of the fight because he knows he's got the strongest Nash on his team, and already taking that advice into consideration that I gave him. There's places you can be that's more proactive on the map than with the sniper. He's got the flank onto Lady Luck, using his movement advantages. Very well with Fred from Subway. Supermans him with the sniper. That was incredible. So I'm staying on board with Fred from Subway. That was such a beautiful shot. He's looking for another one down on the B. He's not going to find the headshot, not going to find the body shot, but I don't think it's going to matter. Fred looking over at C. He's caught out the enemy team's sniper. That's going to be Naysayer. I don't think Naysayer knows what Fred from Subway is. So if Naysayer pops up for even a second too long, Fred should have no difficulty connecting with the headshot here. Oh, Naysayer flirting with death. Fred's gonna go for it, but not gonna find it now, Fred. His presence has been noted, so now he has to move out of the hiding, take a more aggressive stance on the map, being able to get more body shots here. Naysayer not connecting with any headshots. Fred can hit him, but Naysayer puts him in the dirt with a huge pop shot. Fred, you just got embarrassed on stream, baby. Not gonna be rewatching that one with a smile on his face. Naysayer now on our screen is gonna be looking over at Solid Mantella. Can't find anything on that one. This was a huge kill. It's completely given them map momentum back as they are gonna be taking the A hill here. He's over on that one. It's gonna be Transfiction, jumping aboard Transfiction on the A hill at the moment. Looks like having a little bit of a lag issue right there, but now back in the fight as Harrison gets the first good headshot onto Mantella here. Gill, and she's gonna have to re-rotate back around the B because they've just lost control of that one. Point lead in favor of the Locust team at the moment. Here comes Gearlet, one versus one against Gumby Wright. Takes out the first one. Now Harrison with the Lance are completely caught in there. They have control of Winch. You can see the damage being dealt. The support that Gearlet is getting right now is so valuable. She's going to be able to get into the B. He'll break out that one. The lone defender is Transfiction. Coming through, has backup from Solid Mantella. Oh, Prizey is going to be going for the flank, but Solid Mantella knows exactly when Prizey's going to come around the corner and dominates him as Gearlet. Doing fine, just capping hills, doing work as Solid Mantella is picking up the kill. So I want to jump on board with her. Solid Mantella with the Nasher out. Going to be going for the flank. No one knows where she is. She's going for the trip cap. She may have completely caught Naysayer off guard. He doesn't know that she's behind him. Gearlet's there as well. Naysayer goes down with sniper rifle in hand. Pricey needs to come. Huge, he needs to go to the bush now. He can't find his way around the wall. He gets in, denying the domination. That means it's going to happen to cap from 6 seconds again. But I don't think it's going to matter because they have complete control of the enemy team. Kill, get themselves around number four. That's 3-1.
Great play there from both teams, and Naysayer, well, he'll be very, very pleased winning out on the sniper battle. Now, of course, that's like waving a red rag to a bull for another sniper. Now it's all on. One sniper's had gotten one up over the other, and he's going to be looking for his revenge. It was Fred,
Fred,
wasn't it?
Yeah, it was Fred picking up the sniper. I want to jump on board with him because, like you said, poor Naysayer has got a target painted to his head now. Fred, he's got to redeem himself. He got that Superman at the start of the game, which was absolutely hype on to Pricey. Can he get another one? The person's floating down the ramp. He's very patient, but Naysayer finds it. He's doing absolute work with this rifle. We were non-believers. We went from Fred from Subway. We're non-believers, man. I'm staying on my boy Naysayer right now because he's doing absolute work with the rifle in hand. I would like to see him play a little bit more aggressive with that sniper. Could stand to play more forward positions, mind you, and get better angles. I'll be looking for Perfidy. Fred hits the body shot, but that's not going to be the money shot right there. Naysayer moving up. That's Fred in his sights. Last time these two had a sniper battle was Naysayer, who won it out in the end. But there is going to be a flank. Naysayer's got to be careful pulling out that Nash. A very smart play. Gearlet in the one versus one. If she wins this, it's going to be a trip cap coming through. Naysayer, he's able to get the break. Is he able to get the kill? No, Fred hits him in the back with a beautiful shot of Perfidy. Makes his way over as well. And that's going to be the fourth round win over the Thunder from Down Under. Up 4-1.
Well, the round number three blip in the march towards victory of Thunder from Down Under. Just a moment there. Actually, have I got the team names the wrong way around?
Yes, Thunder from Down Under are winning 4-1 right now over Freak Show.
Yeah, so I'm correctly getting, you know, capping the blue scores, but let me just fix
that. Just had the names in the wrong spot. That's all right. In the meantime here, I want to jump on board with Perfidy, who's been doing absolute work for the team. 80 seconds spent dead, 14 kills, 13 downs as well. So not only has he been controlling the winch well, utilizing the cross lancer to perfection. So Perfidy, one versus one, needs to get this shot, needs to do it now, not connecting with anything, trying to get the wall bounces off, but it's just not hitting. Perfidy gets the first really good shot, needs to go for the up A, needs to go for the play. Out of that one, you can see Harrison has gone down. Gumby Riot trying to get the revive. Not in time, but Fitty needs to connect. Gets the first one. Can he get the second one? Is able to find it. Teammate downs him. But Fitty got to go for that three cap. You need to make the aggressive play now. It's a three versus three. Oh, the thing's down. Pricey's not watching it, but he gets the turnaround back and forth with Pricey. Now, Sniper in hand. Fred gonna connect with the body shot. Not as hard as the headshot, but it will do. Fred now with the Sniper out, trying to look over, support his team any way he can. Remember, these are 20-second respawn times. Every single kill matters. Fred gets the body shot onto Harrison. Would have liked to get the headshot there, and actually gets it down because that first shot connected. Connects with an active sniper. That's about 90% of the damage. So even with Harrison being the slightest bit damage, allows Fred to get the down. Very wise play. Gets the break and backs out. Doesn't find the headshot onto Pricey. Rotates back around to the top of the hill. Gila getting the kill onto Naysayer. Fred still somehow doing work with that sniper. Misses the body shot onto Gumby Riders. But Fitty cleans him up anyway. Still three shots left in the chamber. For Fred from Subway. Looking for a shot onto Pricey. Pricey picks up the sniper. Fred absolutely watches it, but it's not going to matter because Gearlet has his back. Finishes him off. That's Gearlet and Perfidi just doing absolute work, putting on a clinic. Round number six, going over to Thunder from Down Under. They're two rounds away from taking this series 7-1.
All right, got everything sorted out from a technical perspective. Of course, Thunder Down Under with the longest name in the world. But they are 5-1 up. And their score at the moment, just nicely bracketing that that loss to the Freak Show.
Yeah, Freak Show really struggling to get any footing in this game. They got one round under their belt, so obviously improving from last time, but it's going to be the sides being switched here. So back to 10-second respawns, no weapons on the map. I'm jumping on one for Perfidi. Tip of the spear for her team. He's going to be moving on in, getting some great Lancer fire in on Transfixion. Can't do too much. Naysay actually been challenging Perfidi right now, but Perfidi absolutely bodies him. How's he get away with that? Then up Ace, looking for another one, looking for the second body. Can't find it. Deciding to back off as a teammate is there. Get control of me. That's what you need to do. Never take those risky fights when you know you have backup. Why take a 1v1 when you can take a 2v1? And I love how Perfidi rotates around because Gearlet had communicated that there was someone overextended with no way to escape. Perfidi, rotate back around with your Lancer. We'll take him out. They say gets the kill onto Sword Mantella. She goes down. Perfidi making a way on in. Looks for the kill onto Naysayer. Fred from Subway picks up Transfixion. Goes down, and Perfidi going for that recap maybe. Making a way through. Getting the cross Lancer down. Lancer in the back. Gotta be real careful with how they take this next approach. They have a point lead, so the last thing they want to do is overextend and make themselves vulnerable to a triple cap. See, Fred gets a kill onto Naysayer. Pricey's gonna go for the 1v1 against Solid Man. Perfidi rather. Pricey wins out on that one. So now he's gonna be going for that E heal. He's got Transfixion. A little bit of backup here. Pricey's gonna go wide. Can't get the shots on Fred from Subway. Can he back up Transfixion? He needs to. Fred somehow gets that one. Somehow gets the double. Someone put a muzzle on this man because he's going off right now. Gets that huge double. Retakes the E heal. Point lead. Still in favor of Thunder from Down Under. They only need a couple more minutes to take this one out. Gonna be getting the cross onto Gumby Ryan. He's in a little bit of a precarious situation here. Fred from Subway going for the overextend flank. Mantella gets killed onto Pricey. Fred just absolutely bodies Harrison. He goes down. Transfixion, the next one to be on Fred's hit list. Mantella just completely getting Gumby off the point. They could be going for the free cap here if they are able to get the kill onto Naysay, which they do. This could be another trip cap coming through. The chainsaw kill onto Pricey. He goes down. Another chainsaw as well. 6-1. Thunder from Down Under. They're on an absolute streak and they're not looking like they ever want to slow down.
Yeah, 1 point away from picking up their first win.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, so they've got a point from a bye. Do Thunder Down from Down Under, but this will be their first win of the evening, and they'll be very, very pleased if they can pull it off to finish the evening with a win.
Oh yeah, really, just Perfidi's putting an absolute work right now, but I want to jump on board. What weapons were placed? Actually, no weapons, so opting to X off a weapon. Would have liked to see them put that sniper rifle down again, because Naysay was doing quite an amount of work with it, but Perfidi going up against Pricey. Showing a ball with Pricey this time. He's getting a huge one shot onto Perfidi, but unfortunately he couldn't win the 2v1 as Fred was there to back him up. Now on board with Fred. He's going to be going for that E heal, going for the flank. Gets a good shot. Connects with the second one, the third one as well, but it's not enough. Gumby Rye just darting in and out. Fred, he's missing every single shot right now. Can't connect with any of them, and finally, body. Gumby Rye gets the heal for his troubles as well. Now he's going to be going for the overextension flank, maybe. Naysayer, though, going to be doing a cheeky, cheeky flank of his own. Going to be breaking up the E heal here. Fred really should have contested that one, and we're going to see him be doing that right now. I want to see it from Naysayer's perspective. Jumping over to Naysayer. He knows that Fred's to his right, gets control of the F heal. Naysay going for the up A and puts Fred in the dirt. That was filthy, I love it. Naysay now sole possession of the F heal, but it's not going to be like that way for much longer. If Lady Luck and Co. have no difficulty taking out Naysay with a barrage of Lance of Perfidy, getting a chainsaw onto Pricey. He goes down. This could be well and truly lights out from Friction, and it is 7-1. Great win from Thunder from Down Under. This team looking really good last week, looking really good today. They're really on the come up, and I'm expecting them to just get better every single week.
Yeah, the more competitive play they get together, the better they will play. So really enjoyed the show tonight that they gave to us. Now, that is the last round. We'll just, before we go on to the bracket, let's choose an MVP.
Oh, it's got to be Perfidy, doing absolute work, getting 1v3 triple kill to secure the trip cap, just pretty much putting the whole team on his back and making a mockery of this game.
All right, let's actually get the graphic up. There you go. What's this thing doing? There you go. All right, so there you go, Plantronics MVP.
Perfidy!
Perfidy! Well done, Perfidy. So you'll go down you'll go down onto our list of MVPs. And what we are working on is exactly what the MVPs are going to be playing or drawing for, I suppose you could say that. We've got 4, maybe 5 weeks of DarkSTAH coming up. So it'll be something like a Steam voucher or Xbox voucher or something like that.
Yep.
So it's worth your while to get yourself on stream, get your name on the MVP board, and get yourself into that draw that we'll do at the end of the series, because there'll be a little bit of swag coming your way. So even if you don't end up taking home the $100 from one of the week's weekly prize pools, you're still in with a chance to take something home for your troubles. And, well, Rogie, it's not really trouble, is it? It's good fun playing.
Yeah, and I think we're also doing the raffle as well for the...
Oh, yeah, we got to draw the raffle, so...
Yeah, so while we got 38 people watching, I think it's a great time to get those entries in.
All right, so I'll just put a... just do this and... There you go. Boom. You go, just enter exclamation mark DarkSTAH and you will be in the raffle, and we're going to draw it in a few minutes. And let me just tell you, oh no, we're not actually going to draw it. Remember, no, we carry over the entries from tonight into the playoffs, and then we draw it at the playoffs.
Yes.
There you go, we've got a couple more that are actually entering it. So for some reason, Pricey, you have a space between the exclamation mark and DarkSTAH, so it hasn't entered. So you got to remove that space. Just one word, exclamation mark, DarkSTAH, and then you'll be entered into it. Hey, loving the dark-sided emote there from I Am Arvo. There you go. Sammy knows how. Perfidy, you're entered as well. It's Pricey. You got to enter it, mate. You got to do it again. You got to put exclamation mark, DarkSTAH with no space. And then you'll enter into it. Gumby Riot entering as well. So all of the players from the previous round coming through. Let's get the bracket up so that we can see exactly how things have turned out for the night. Because we will... Well, we can't actually announce who gets through the top four. Theoretically, because we are meant to, you know, add in the scores. But we'll see if it's close. And we need a tiebreaker, then we'll have to wait for the announcement. But if not, we might be able to make the announcement now. So just waiting on Captain Deej and Disciples versus Mikey's Production Studios to be completed, or to at least tell us what their scores are. So let's just have a quick look in Gears of War. Nobody has, they haven't mentioned it. So we've got the bracket up there. Look, I don't think there's any doubt. Cap and Deej will go through, regardless of the result. Mind Freak will go through as well. Mikey Production Studios. Well, let's just do a refresh of this, just so we know that it's counted all of the scores in. I don't think it enters the scores until we've completed the round. So we're going to have to wait, ladies and gentlemen, for that Cap and Deej and Disciples to complete versus Mikey Production Studio. And any indication in Discord or anything like that? I guess they must still be playing.
I can check. They must still be playing. I know it's both teams are quite competent in their own regards, so I'm sure it's going to be a long one. I can check. Doesn't look like anyone said GG across any of the channels, so I'm assuming it's still going. I'll ask my boy Dead Zone Man. Find out what the score is. And if he doesn't reply, it means they're still playing.
Yeah.
But no, that was a great game. I'm really I'm on board with following Thunder from Down Under's progression, because each week it seems like that squad's just getting better and better, and I can't wait to see them play next week as well.
Yeah, it's going to be fantastic. And in fact, there is a good chance that they'll be through into the playoffs.
Oh yeah,
this week. So that's a reminder to everyone. While we're waiting for that round to finish, the playoffs for this week will happen on Thursday night, starting at 8 p.m. AEDT again. It's the top four from tonight. So unfortunately, there's just one team that's going to go, and I think it's going to be Freak Show, because they didn't lose, they didn't win that last match, and they were 0-3 coming through into it. So the top four tonight are going to be Cap and Deej and Disciples, Mind Freak. Sorry, let's just get that bracket up for you. Cap and Deej and Disciples in first seed again. Mind Freak in the second seed. Thunder from Down Under and Mikey Production Studios coming in the third and fourth seeds. And, well, it'll be here on GameStar TV. Rogi, you and I, once again, bringing the Gears of War Darkstar weeklies to Oceania.
Oh, yeah. Loving it.
Now, Perfidy, that's a good question. Yes, we could possibly start earlier if everybody was keen for us to start earlier. So we start at 8 p.m. because, I don't know, there's Western Australian players who complain if we start any earlier. But if there is sufficient motivation for us to bring them earlier, we will. So I'm happy to start things earlier. I mean, it's almost 1 a.m. here in New Zealand for me. So.
Oh, yeah.
Everybody
you'd
helps.
Be on board with that crisis.
So I tell you what, in the Gears of War Discord tomorrow, what I'll do is I'll put a poll up, and we'll get people to vote on whether we start at 7:30 or 8 p.m.
Yeah, sounds good to me.
Well, Rogi, thank you for the casting again tonight.
No worries, it's always a pleasure, Crisis. I love doing what I love, and that's casting Gears.
All right. Well, again, thank you to everyone for joining us tonight. We've had a steady 30 viewers, and that is an improvement off of last week. And I'll be writing that down, and it will form part of the history of Gears of War Esports here in Oceania. GameStar providing you with some support and hopefully getting some connections going as well, so that we can really supercharge the scene here in Oceania. Don't forget, the LAN is happening, E-League LAN on the 22nd of April. That's coming up, brought to you by E-League and GameStar. And we have yet to announce the prizes, but man, everybody knows LAN is where it's at, especially when you are in on console. Remember, the first 20 people who register for the LAN get a free monitor to use for the LAN, itself. Of course, you can't take it home. What you need to do is, once you've bought your ticket to E-League, is send me a PM on Discord. Let me know, and I will make sure that one of those monitors gets reserved for you. Well, that's it for tonight. Thank you for joining us, ladies and gentlemen. This has been a GameStar production. It's been Crisis and Rogi, and we are signing out.